Well, now, according to the Smith Brothers document for this old Myers plow, there's 5 wires I need to hook up to make this thing raise, lower, right, and left. It talks about on the older units, it was a black wire with the fuse, and there it is. And the newer units had a blue wire, dark blue. Well, I don't have a dark blue. And then there's another black wire, which goes out to the solenoids. So here we have red, white, black, and green, and the other black. So that's definitely my power lead, I know that. I don't have a black on this harness, and I don't have a green. Oh, there is a black. I've got red with a white tracer. White. This is a forward wiring harness, by the way. I needed a green. I don't have a green. Here's a black. And what shall we use for green? Let's use dark blue. I went and got some bullet connectors because I hadn't found the original harness for this thing and I was going to hook up those lights. So I guess I'll use all those bullet connectors I got on here. And I think I'll use this big, heavy red one for my power. Maybe I'll use the dark blue like they had originally intended. And instead of green, I'll use gray. And I'll put the FEMA nail connectors on the wires coming up through the floor. But wait, I still need connectors out there. I need 3 bullet connectors out there for those solenoids. You know what? I think I'll go out there and put those leads on. Because I want to make sure I have those bullet connectors. Because I have to have those bullet connectors. I can always use a spade connector in here somewhere. Only 3 come out here. The red, the white, and the black. I messed it up again. Okay, so green's gonna be white with the blue tracer. White wire has to go to the solenoid. The mark the motor. This one's white, but on the other side it's pink and down inside it's red. Takes care of the solenoids. So I want my wires. Oh. I should have 4 wires that need connectors. Nice driffers, rotten cutters. Oh, yeah. A little dab do ya? Now, the only thing that remains is to supply power to it and get a relay. Now I'll go do a costume change and get back on this. So with all the control wiring done, except for the solenoid that needs to go right here, I need to find a solenoid that can go right here. There's one. Need that until summer. And yes, I disconnected the battery already. I also hate dropping these in the snow. Do I have a pair of channel locks with me?
No.
Well, I thought I pushed the record button. I just wasted all that talk and instruction. And I ain't doing it again. This came out a whole lot easier than expected. I would gladly accept it. Well, what you missed was me taking these vice grips and clamping them onto the electrical terminals so I could get those nuts broke loose. I couldn't recreate it, though. One step closer to the plow. So it's gonna go behind the ridge and it's gonna get cold. Let's see, where's my solenoid? What ought to do? No. It's gone. The other screw is gone. I hate when I do that. Need my energizing wire. Now the energizing lead was the white wire that was cut too short in this furnace. And I have some more white wire. And I'm out of butt connectors. However, I do have some shrink tube. If you connect a wire like that, me neither. Don't ever try to slide your shrink tubing over that while it's hot. You won't make it. Now, when it comes to the big cables for the motor, they go on here. Well, I ain't over there at that other shop. We didn't really find anything that matched up the way I wanted it to. So it's back to make your own. So, using our scrap bits. I'm just marking it. Now, I have absolutely no ring terminals whatsoever. We're just gonna have to make some, I guess. You strip back a good 2.5 inches of insulation. Separate your strands. You got 7 strands in this. And then, my post is a 5/16. This screwdriver is about a 5/16. Make 2 strands from one side. Get your needly nose pliers. I know I brought my solder up here. The sun has now dropped behind the ridge. It's getting cold. Let's see, which way was it? The tools are getting cold. Yes, the motor will ground to the frame. But what they have found, according to the guys at Smith Brothers Services in New Jersey, that galvanic corrosion occurs because of the steel bolts going into the aluminum housing. And you can reduce or prevent that by running a ground cable instead of allowing it to ground through the housing. My ring is too small. It is too small. Rats and fully. Too small for that bolt, and the cable's too short to reach the battery, where it could fit on. Well, just have to spread that ring. Did go. Positive is connected, but for now it can ground through the frame. Oh, I neglected to make another cable. That one's too small as well. The solder's all built up. Gloves. I forgot I needed three cables, not two. I didn't make sure my copper wire stayed lined up when I soldered it. I made a problem for myself. Now when it comes to my energizing wire, you're supposed to take off of a keyed switch before it will energize. Well, I ran to the black wire out here, but there's no keyed anything out here. I suppose alternator maybe. So now I'll have to change the wire inside, and I hate to waste a good bullet connector doing that, but I need another cable here. What shall I do? Well, I ain't a soldering this one. This is gonna get the wrap it around there treatment. Nothing. Don't tell me that. Oh, I went the wrong way. Still nothing. Is it grounded? Do I have... Yeah, I got contact there. Do I not have a grounded solenoid? Well, my solenoid's grounded. Oh, come on! It worked! I'll swap them. As he smacks his positive cable into the ground. Still nothing! Fairly disgusted. Doesn't matter if my energizing wire energizes or not. Solenoid doesn't want to work. It's got to be grounding, or the lack of grounding. Well, that's just as irritating as it gets. I guess I'll just have to go buy one. The starter actually operates the solenoid for the other starter. It's a relay for a relay. I wonder if this has to be grounded on the other side of that terminal. See if we can make some sparks. It needs to be grounded.
I ain't never seen one like that before.
I knew they made them, but I ain't never seen one. Well, my motor didn't turn, did it, when I did that. The plow is in default mode. With no coils energized, we'll turn to the left. I feel better. I suppose now I ought to give it a little bit of alternator service. Well, I thought I was going to hook up the lights today too, but I guess I'll have to save that for another one. Oh, man. So for Redneck Restoration, I can't even say it right. So for Redneck Restoration's This Cold Truck, I'm Jeff Bradshaw. Yeah, I've lost one already. There it is.
Man, UPS, these are like, you know, wide open. Yeah, no problem changing these.
Will they take you back?
Huh?
Will they take you back?
Oh, probably. Why, do you want me to go back, Dougie? Do you need a job?
Huh? I have four of those connectors. I should have five. No, I should have four. So, you ever wonder why they only put four in a package that'll hold 20? Green? Some people just have no clue. When I drop sockets in the snow. No. Yes. At least there's no snow in the middle. Now the energizing lead is the white wire that was cut too short out of this harness. So, there's my too short white wire. And I have some more white wire. Now the energizing lead was the white wire that was cut too short in this harness. Doing out. Apparently there's a breach in the fence. You should never do this sort of thing around live electrical lines. That's why. I know, you wanted to see me plow something. I ain't got nothing to plow. Like I can't find my other glove. Oh, there it is. Nice hot wood stove inside.